in a sort of business context rather than a sort of educational context, are you picking up again that sense of people coming to a conclusion that to really optimize for this sort of hybrid world where the office doesn't completely go away, but online and working at home is a, you know, pretty non-controversial, you know, norm. Do you get the sense that people realize that they've got to rethink a bit more strategically? It strikes me as that this is almost a catalyst for another wave of process re-engineering, using the technology, but also redesigning, as the title of this webinar suggests, the way that we work to leverage that technology. To me, it has echoes of what we went through in the early to mid-90s when we, you know, put in this first big wave of ERP technology. Initially, the technology was a bit underwhelming. It took people a while to figure out that they needed to re-engineer their processes as well as just put the technology in. It feels a little bit like that to me at the moment. Is that something that you, on your travels, begin to see with the clients that you're working with?
Yeah, Ben, I think you're spot on there on what we're seeing as we talk to different clients, as you see kind of people are planning for this post-pandemic. Do we go back to the office? Do we not? You see a lot of conversation on the hybrid focus. There is some even saying, you know, let's work from home completely. But I do think there's a portion of it that allows for some of that hybrid to really enable innovation, to being able to come in, collaborate at times, to be able to kind of whiteboard together as a team. So people are really trying to think through that piece. I think right now everyone is trying to think through the first step, but to your point, there's going to be a strategic conversation that we have to have as well, because the processes the way they are today, while maybe okay working remote, there's really just some optimization and things that could be better though. Better experiences, how do we give people more ways to be able just to log on their computer and have the what they need to do their jobs appear for them so they don't have to go and search for things? Because sometimes it was easier to be on site. You could download things, you can go get something from your neighbor. The connectivity might have been a bit different. So we have to think about how do we reimagine the process? How do we better create ways for people to collaborate remotely? I think that's just going to be how we're in the future going to be working. So you see the technology trying to evolve quickly. To your point, there's lots of patterns that are coming in. But I think the other thing we're seeing, even the automation technology, is this just foot on the gas pedal to be able to evolve it. You know, move the RPA technology, robotics came out early on, probably about a decade or so ago. Now it's about how do I put machine learning? How do I put AI into the conversation? How do I just rethink in general the experience for an employee and their work? So it's important. And I think the thing that we see is people realizing now it's not just all the technology. You have to rethink process, and you have to rethink about how do you educate people to understand how to use the technology and how to also submit opportunities to be able to move their orgs forward